What is up, guys? It's Mike Tsumomo here, and welcome to my YouTube channel, and most of all, welcome to the episode of Where is the Guru? And, this quest is basically a side quest, a Easter egg quest towards the sect camp, but, there are four books. Two in the desert, aka Varant, one in Mirchana, and one in Nordmar. So let's get those damn books. It's gonna be nice XP. It's gonna be a bit rewarding. Not that much though, but
I can only hope so.
It's time to get the Guru. Bakaresh. Now, the first book is located on this small island over here. I'm first gonna explore this island over here, because my character is not full built yet, by far. Because, combat capabilities is maxed, hunting capabilities is maxed. I only need staff combat, which is optional. Entire staff combat was basically optional, but I forgot to Google, by the way, where to get this one. But either way, once I got this one is maxed as well, which is the magic skills. Smithing skills, I still need these two. This one is optional, this one is a must. All these thieving skills must be learned, alchemy is done. And acrobatics, endurance of the wolf, and disease are a must. And resistance cold I get through my Nordmarian armor, and resistance to heat I will get through my Ashishin garment. But let's go to that island over there. There will be a small army of undead in this vicinity. But like I said, I still need quite a bit of XP before I make any rash decisions like killing Khan. I expected a bit more mobs, but there should be at least a few undead near a chest and a sacrificial altar, if I'm correctly, that is. And every little bit of XP that I can get, all the better. What are you guys doing? Come on, stupid skeletons. Why why are you stuck? Come. Come, skeletons. Well, well. An undead priest and only one skeleton to go on. One of the strongest shields in the game. Not that this character needs a shield, but... only four mobs, eh? Well, that's what you can call disappointing. Alright, so let's TP to Bakaresh again and then go towards the first book of Where is the Guru? Now keep in mind that just like the Cro-Magnon books in Gothic 1, you have to get them at a certain, you know, at a certain path, if you will, on a certain, you know, in a certain order. That's the word I was looking for. Alright, so that was island number one out of the third island that we have to go to. First island is inhabited with blood flies and sand lurkers. The second one is infested with blood flies and lizards. And the third one is with ogres and perhaps some lizards or blood flies, I'm not quite sure. But plenty of little beasts. That was island 2. And now towards the ones with the ogres. And with our first, where is the guru chest? Which is a reference to Gothic 1, the second camp. Here we have the first chest. Alright, so let's get ourselves the second book, which is near Braga. Here we have it, guarded by two ogres. Normally I would have cleared the area, but this time apparently I didn't. Now these books contain clues, you know, towards the next chest, but I already know where to find them. Alright, so we got the second chest, which went right over here. So let's go to the third one, which is near Selden and the Nordmarian Pass. all that you have to do basically is follow these totems. It's the same totems that will guide you towards the portal where Zardus will go to. But you don't have to follow them entirely, but they will guide you towards the spot that you need to go to. It's quite confusing, you know. It can become quite confusing, let me put it that way. So, you know, just following this route is the easiest way. A King Sorrel, I like those. Too bad there is no plant with thieving, because it's the only thing that I still need, and smithing. Oh, smithing is already maxed. The only thing that I still have to do is learn these two capabilities. Thieving is 40 out of 100. So 60 left, plus, you know, the requirements to train those skills. It's a bit laggy, but once you come to this road, just keep following it up. Lose a couple of chests if you can. And then once before you go that way, you're gonna go this way. And there we have it. Book number 3. Which is guarded by a couple of skeletons. I think about 5 to 6 maybe. That's the chest. Let me first loot the shit here. I like that amulet. No, not quite. You know, I still need to get 100. Because of the fact that, you know, wearing amulets, rings, and what have you doesn't work in order to learn the skills. At least as far as I know. pretty dang good sword, but mine is better. You also get a couple of plants. Where is it? One which gives 100 to everything, so if you're low on health, stamina and mana at one time, you know, you can consume this, everything is maxed again. I never use it. And also the tear or something like that. That makes no difference. Let's go to book number 5. 4, I mean. Which is the last one, and which is located at Nordmar. So let's go to the Fire Clan. Once you found this tomb, go this way. Climb onto this rock and jump to there. Here we have the final book. Let's meet the guru. Well, that was... Where's Boo? He's dead. Let's quickly go to the Hammer Clan. Get my last Nordmarine armor piece. And then I can fully focus on getting my skills maxed without the worry of my collectibles.
Show me your goods.
No, I really don't need them, so I'm just gonna sell them. Because I need all the gold I can make, because training my capabilities are going to be quite expensive. Right, so my armory collection is complete.
Teach me something about being a smith.
Quite close to leveling up. I literally need about 90 XP. And let's quickly kill some animal near Sylden, whether it's a bison or whether it's a black troll, makes no difference. I need to get level up so I can get myself heavy armor. Hey, flame berries. Not that I really need flame berries at the moment. Now, pairing, you know, forge pure magical weapons is optional because there is basically only one blade, which is pure magic ore. And if I'm correctly, I already got a pure magic ore blank. But that one is probably a two-hand if I remember correctly. I could be wrong, you know.
I could have told you that.
What do you want?
So 25 learning points for those.
How can I use heavy armor properly?
Most people make the mistake of not putting their armor on properly. All parts of the armor must be firmly connected, not so tightly that you cannot move, but tightly enough so that there are no weak spots left in the armor.
And I also need this one still, this one still. I need this one, you know, all of this. This one is finished, and I need most of this, you know. Even though this one I get through armor, this one I get through armor, this one I get through armor. I'm willing to cheat for those, you know, but first, getting this one at ready, you know, when it comes to thieving, I need 100, I'm 40, so that means I need 6 levels in thieving alone, you know. And then we still have to learn these things. And this one will cost me 10, I think, 15, I'm not quite sure, it's gonna be expensive, most definitely. But the most important one is finished. So, kill Zardas, kill Zubin, kill the Orc Chieftains. I didn't do that one yet. Let's first kill our good friend Zardas. Alright, Zardas is dead, the king is dead. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and if you like what you see, subscribe to my channel, hit the like button if you want to see a Gothic series hardcore run. And I hope to see you guys in the next episode where we're gonna start killing the orcs. Hopefully I won't mess things up when it comes to, you know, securing Loras from death, you know, because I need him for most of my thieving capabilities. But it is time for the Chieftains of the Orcs 4. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.